I'm slowly dreaming. clean every single day.
Thank you.
up your hands, close your eyes, and worship Jesus.
Your will be done. listen. Every time you come to this altar, and even for you guys, never forget who you're singing about. Never forget who you're singing to. Alright? I know it's so easy. Oh, we have service. There's praise and worship, then there's the Word. There's praise and worship and the Word. We know the routine. We know the schedule, right? It becomes mundane. You're not singing to them. You're singing to Him. You lead us in praise and worship through your praise and worship, right? And we go there with you. Yes, you have an obligation to try to lead us and guide us there. And then we press in, right? We shouldn't have to be pumped and primed and follow anybody but the leading of the Lord, amen? We follow Him. We press in with them. They shouldn't have to drag us, amen? And we can all get there. We can all get to the presence of the Lord and say to Him, for Him, about Him, right? Like, I've got songs I like more than others, yeah. But every one that we sing, never forget who we sing about and who we're singing to, right? That's what's important. It's not the same mundane and over and over and over and over, right? Get into the presence of God. He's worthy. We need to glorify Him. Lift Him up. He does so much for us. Blessed us with so much. Loves us so much. Grace and mercy just every single day. He's worthy of our praise. Amen. We should praise Him with everything that we have. We don't know when we'll take our last breath. We share the breath of God. Amen. We should honor Him with the same breath that He breathed into us, into our nostrils. Never forget whose breath you share and what you do with it. The power of life and death is in the tongue. What you say, what you sing, what comes out, amen? Life and death, amen? All right, you guys can be seated real quick. Josh, you bring that over here for me. Come by the Lord. Thank you guys so much for being here tonight. We love each and every single one of you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's awesome, and it's very encouraging to see young men and young women still that want to come out and praise Jesus, amen? That don't want to sit home and say, well, I'm too tired, I had school, you know, school started back and I'm not used to a school routine, so I need to stay at home, or I've got practice, you know, I've got to play sports after school, so I'm tired, need to go to practice, yada, 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 right? There's a million reasons. The devil in the world will give you a million reasons to miss church, amen? They just will. They'll give you every reason in the world to lay out of church, and I know a lot of you are, several teams are playing sports on Sundays now. That's the craziest thing I've ever heard in my life, right? I don't even think professional sports should play on Sunday. Like, I love football, man, but they should play on Sunday, amen? Amen?
Amen.
What the? Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Is this thing on? Check. Testing.
Good night.
So y'all want to play sports on Sundays then? I already stepped on your toes, sorry. Man, jeez Louise. I'm supposed to do nothing on Sundays. Me and Matt was talking about that. Earlier, they used to take people out and stone them for doing work on Sundays, right? The Lord said, look, you can go get your ox out of the ditch, yeah, if it's necessity, right? But you shouldn't be just out working. You're supposed to have that total day of rest, right? They were like, we caught him working on the Sabbath. Take him out, throw him in the hole, and throw rocks at him. You know, and now we're like honoring major league sports and things, so, you know, on Sundays. All right, so listen up. Here we go. So tonight, for the next few minutes, we're going to kind of go back to the beginning, almost back to the basics, I guess, if you will, through love and grace. So tonight I'm going to talk to you guys about love and grace, obviously salvation, staying in that right relationship with God. Every now and again, we just need that refresher course, right? Those scriptures, those main, bold, that standout kind of scriptures. And here's the thing, I may read some familiar scriptures to you tonight that you say, oh yeah, I've heard that. But tonight you need to receive it. Amen. The Lord's put this on my heart and dealing with me about it. There was no other message that I could preach because I can't get away from this. Amen. I was like, well, Lord, this is kind of like back to the basics. But you never know who's going to be here. You never know who's going to show up who may have never heard these scriptures, never heard about love and grace and mercy and righteousness and all these things. And every now and again, some of us that's been in the thing for a while just need to hear it and get a reminder. Amen. Said a lot of people, how many people you're like, they got saved? I thought they were saved. They got rededicated? I thought they were fine. Right? And now some of you guys that are coming into the youth from a children's church and getting older, they say, a lot of times, guys, it just clicks and we realize what He done for us, right? If we understand the cost that Jesus paid for us. So then we want to make things right with Him, and we would say, well, I thought I was saved. I thought I kind of said the prayer and stuff, but now I get it. Like, I really understand the weight of this thing and what He done and what it means to live for Him. I want to go to the altar and say the sinner's prayer or rededicate or just make things right again. So that's kind of what tonight is all about. Amen? So none of us in this room tonight need to say, well, I've heard that before. Well, that's the same old same. I've heard that scripture 1,000 times. How many times do you hear scriptures and just say, yeah, I know, I'd repeat that one with you, right? Receive this thing. It's the Word of God. It's amazing, right? It's a beautiful thing. Amen? It's the Word of God. It's a alive, it's living. These scriptures, you can read it one day and then read it the next to get something totally different. I don't know how many scriptures I've preached off of and got like 10 different messages off one scripture. That's how we know it's alive and active, right? I mean, there's always something that matches and goes along with these things. But we're going to hit love and grace and talking about the love of God and His faithfulness and how much He cares for us and loves us and just all of these things, all these reminders. But receive this tonight. Just don't blow it off as another youth service, another let's get the cake and ice cream and let's go, you know, I've heard all this before and yada, 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 right? Receive the word that God has for you. Not just pray as, you know, as we open up and say, God, give me revelation of the word. Father, let this speak to me. Get it down on the inside of me, my soul. Don't let it go in here and out here. Let it soak in and resonate and stay in here. Amen? Don't let it go here and out. Right? Don't let me miss it from here to here. Let's get it in here and get it in our hearts. Amen? Get it in our side of our soul, something we can hang on to, right? We want like the meat and potatoes kind of stuff, right? The comfort food, the home foods, right? You know, you eat like a biscuit or like pancakes. You eat pancakes, like, man, these are so filling. You're starved to death in like 30 minutes. You're like, I was stuffed an hour ago. Now I'm about to starve to death, right? We want something that's going to go in there and hang on, something that we can live on and hold on to. When you go to school tomorrow, you don't say, man, what an awesome youth service. You go to school tomorrow and be like, I just forgot everything we talked about, everything I know. I'm just doing what they say. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just going with the crowd, go with the flow, right? I know it's hard to go against the current, but sometimes you just have to, amen?
Yeah.
You just have to. It's, well, it's just easier to go with the flow. That flow will flow you right into the gates of hell. I smile when I say it. I'm being nice to you. I'm just telling you the truth. Amen. One day I'm going to stand with the Lord and He's going to say, Charlie, everything you told those teenagers over the years that you've been doing this, you know what I mean? I'm going to get an account for all this. You guys think you've got a lot to hold up. You know what I mean? Look at the weight, you know. I get an account for everything I stand up here and tell you. And all the years I've been doing this since 2012. It's a lot. You know what I mean? So we have to make sure we're all accountable and we're preaching the truth. I can't get you up here and be like, Charlie's so cool and he always gives us a great message. Let me have cake and ice cream. I love youth service. That's going to get us nowhere, amen? That's going to get us nowhere. Nowhere. We've got to press into the word, press into the truth, and get you guys ready to fight. Listen, the devil isn't concerned with cake and ice cream and how good you feel after youth service, amen? He wants to steal, kill, destroy. He wants to ruin your relationship with Jesus. He wants to destroy your soul, kill your hope, kill your faith, kill your soul. Amen? There's a real fight going on out there. And we talk about, you know, the fight. Listen, it's not flesh and blood, right? Principalities, right? All the unseen. Spiritual warfare. There is an enemy out there that desires to kill you and your faith. And we have to be ready for it at all times. Amen?
Amen.
All right, let's stand. Let's stand. I'm going to just read a scripture. So I got about 17 tonight, so just buckle in. We'll go through it quick. It's only 7:50, so you're good. All right. Romans 5:8. Let me quote that. Romans 5:8. That's on the board. Cheers. God shows us His. God shows. It was bad. I can't. It's behind me. God shows His love for us while we were still sinners, still messed up, still in sin, still drinking, smoking, cussing, lying, pornography, everything, sneaking into mom and dad's medicine cabinet, sneaking into mom and dad's liquor cabinet. While we were doing all of those things, right, Christ still died for us. Knowing what we were going to do, knowing what He was going to the cross for, He loved us and still gave us a chance. He still said, I love them enough to give them a chance. There's still enough grace and mercy for them to give them a chance. While we were still, He didn't say, well, God, once they clean up a little bit, once they do a little better, yes, I'll go and be a sacrifice for them. No, He said, I'm ready, I'm willing, I will become sin, and I will die for them on the cross. Amen? All right, you can be seated. You guys can be seated in the presence of the Lord. So think about this. In everything that goes on in our day-to-day lives, every time we mess up, we feel bad. I hope you have conviction, you know, in your life, that quickening, right, when you do something. If you can watch porn and feel nothing and just be like, ah, don't bother me. If you can drink and just be like, ah, don't bother me. Smoke, ah, you can tell a lie, don't really bother me. I'll tell another lie in 5 minutes. You know what I mean? That's bad. That's bad. If you tell a lie, you're like, man, I wish I wouldn't cuss. Man, I wish I wouldn't lie. Man, I wish I wouldn't. That's a good thing, right? Obviously, not that you're doing those things, but if you don't want to do them, you should have that conviction, that quickening in your spirit that says, don't say that, man, you told a lie. Listen, I'd rather be in trouble with man than God, right? Like, yeah, you might get in trouble for lying. 9 times out of 10, your lie finds you out. And, you know, or you just keep lying and lying and lying and lying. And then you're trying to remember what you said. You know what I mean? You're like, man, you got to get them. Remember, remember, remember. All this stuff. And you get caught in it. and you should have told the truth and took it to begin with. But now you're labeled as a liar when you should just let it go. All of those things that we battle, right, that should bother us. We should want better and want to do better. God died for you on the cross. 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, He made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. What does that mean? Jesus Christ became, he who knew no sin, the perfect Son of God, just took on the weight of the most vile, the stuff that he hates. He hates the sin, right? Took it on. Well, it took that weight onto him, took it to the cross, become the righteousness of God in him. What does that mean? We can be in right standing with God. Because we were not, right? At times, you know what I mean? We were not in right standing unless you're making the sacrifices, unless you were cleaning yourself up. You know what I mean? Everybody's going out and killing animals right and left, giving all these burnt offerings and sacrifices and all these things, right? Because they were trying to stay in right standing with God. But Jesus said, I will go. I'll be that lamb for them, the sacrifice for you. Now get this tonight. All of this is for you. Just pretend like it's me and you in this room tonight. It's just us. It's just me and you. Just me and you. Just me and you. Right? I'm talking to you. Okay, Big Mac? Just me and you. Because this is to you. This is to you. Alright? Now, we're not just reading this as a general scope and saying, this is for you. It's for you. He knew that you were going to need grace. He knew that you were going to be born into sin, right? But he said, I want to give them a chance. I want to give them love. I want to give them grace. I want to give them, I want to tear that veil. I want to give them access to God. I want them to have righteousness in God, right? I want them to have right standing for man. Think about how crazy that is for man to have right standing with God. Is that not amazing or what?
Yes.
Yes, it is. You're correct. Yes, you win a prize. You get a piece of cake later. Give God good praise. Give him a praise. Amen. Praise God. There you go. That's better. We'll hit some jumping jacks here in just a second. Be in right standing with God, knowing that when we talk, guys, the same thing I just said about praise and worship and singing, who we're singing to, who we're singing about, in prayer. Don't just say a mundane prayer at night. I mean, how many of us are guilty? Like we just, oh, thank you, Lord, for watching over us today. Keep us safe tonight, God. Watch over folks today. Like, remember who we talk to. I mean, I know we get hung up on the prayer. God is great, God is good, let us thank for our food, let us thank for our food, give us our living. You know what I mean? Like, you just fast forget, I'm starving to death. You know, thank you, Jesus. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, when we're talking to God, talk to God, right? I mean, have that respect and that dignity, that relationship with him to know, I mean, when you pray to him, talk to him, mean what you say, right? Thank you, God, for keeping my heart beating and my lungs breathing. Thank you, God, for your grace. Thank you for taking on my sin. I don't know what to pray about, or I don't know how to pray. I always ran out of things to say. Look at all of this, man. Like, thank you for becoming sin and dying for me. Thank you for going to the cross. Thank you for being born of a virgin and carrying that cross, being my example while you were here. And thank God that you're alive forevermore, and God rose you from the dead. Thank you for the miracles. Thank you for my faith, for everything that you've done. That God, I know if you live on the inside of me and I have your spirit, yeah, I know it ain't me that heals, Lord, but through me, I can heal with these hands. I can lay hands on the sick, they'll recover. Like, look at all of these things we have to be thankful for, right? I mean, pray as long as you need to pray, right? You say, well, gosh, will you sing and stay up at night and pray for 2 hours? If that's what you need to. If you want 2 hours, get 2 hours. 30 minutes, 5, whatever, right? But just don't sit there and just forget who we're talking to. Have the respect to know we're talking to God Almighty that went to the cross for us. Amen? Like respect him enough and love him as much as he loves us to give him the respect that not say these same old prayers over and over and over and press into this thing. I mean, this is what it's all about, right? Jesus Christ died for this. He gave his life for us. Why? Not to wake up and go to school and live the same life day in and day out and just be the same, that man, I'm just missing something. Man, I wish there was more to my life. Yeah, I'd love to see miracles. Yeah, I'd love to see. Then go after it. You know, amen? Go after it. Then you want to see miracles, then pray and fast for them. You want to be a healer? You want to have a faith healing ministry, whatever it is? If that's in the Lord, if that's his will, amen, go after it. Amen? Pray and fast for it. God, if it'll be your will, let me have a healing ministry. If it's your will, let me be a missionary. Let me be an evangelist. Let me go around everywhere I go. But all of us are evangelists. We always look for the stage and the platform and everything else. When you're evangelists right now, amen, share and carry the gospel everywhere you go every day. Do you understand? School is the largest platform you will ever have. You're in it right now. You are living evangelists right now. You're around hundreds of boys and girls, not thousands. I mean, some of these schools are enormous. Thousands of people, and we just walk by them. Listen, we got to start looking at people through the eyes of grace and say, she's going to heaven or hell. He's going to heaven or hell. They're going to heaven or hell, heaven or hell, heaven or hell. And then start caring. Where are they going? And you've got the hope and the grace and glory on the inside of you, and we don't share it. It's almost being like, hey, look at this burning building. They're up there on the top floor, and the bottom's on fire. I could put it out. I could put it, you know, I could get a ladder up there and get them out, but I'm just going to sit and watch it burn. That's what it's like when we don't share the gospel, right? We're like, look at them. Look at this, man. This building's on fire. They're on the top floor. They're vacuuming the floor. They're just like, earpods, where y'all come. They're in there, you know, vacuuming the floor. And you're just like, wow, watch this building collapse with them in it. This is going to be wild. Right? Because we can say, no, hey, listen. We can help you. We can save you. Go up there and say, hey, you're crazy thing. Your building's on fire, man. Hey, get down from here, right? If you see people living in sin, you know they live in sin. Listen, newsflash, they're not going to like you calling them on it, but we should do it anyway. Amen? Do it out of love. Don't go up to them and be like, you're a vile, awful sinner, and you're going to die and go to hell. You know what I mean? Go at it about love, though, and say, hey, you know, can I pray for you? I know what you're dealing with. I've dealt with it. Have a testimony. Share a testimony. Whatever. Plant that seed, right? Get in there and plant that seed and let God move through you and onto them. Listen, even if they say, well, no, blah, blah, blah. Oh, they didn't receive it, Lord. I went on a limb and they didn't receive it. Now, those seeds were planted. I'll just tell you, you know, even before, you know, people try to talk to me about the Lord before I was saved, I'd be like, yeah, no, man, I'm good, whatever. Guess what happened? I always thought about it later. It always comes back to him. It always will come in there, right? Jesus gave his life for this. Let's give our life for him, right? That's what it's about. It's not about coming in here and hearing another message. It's not about just going through the motions and going right back to the same old saying. Yes, it's easier said than done, but we've got to start doing it. If you'll start doing it, it gets easier to do, right? Press into the word. Go after Jesus Christ. Go after this word. Go after prayer. Go after fasting. We can't sit and say, Lord God, just bless these hands to heal in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Heal right now. It didn't work. What happened? He's not a genie in a bottle, right? We don't treat God as a genie in a bottle. We've got to go after this thing and believe him for it and get the undoubt out of us and say, God, I know if I lay my hands on the sick, they will recover. I know there can be healing. I know there can be miracles. You've done it before. You'll do it again. Amen? Hearing testimonies and healing testimonies, all of these things. Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. We're all going to have to die. We've got to pay the wages. Amen? The wage has to be paid, right? It is death. But thank God that Jesus went. He said, listen, I'll die. I'll take the sin. I'll take the wage right here. I'll pay the price. I will go. When he said it is finished, if you actually look that up, I was looking some stuff up on it, that's an accounting term. I always thought he just said, it is finished. You know, I come and I did what I was supposed to do. I lived, I had my life. I did the example. I got the disciples. I'm on the cross. Jesus, our God, this is what I came to do. I've done it. It is finished. I'm dying now. What he was saying, when he said, it is finished, it meant paid in full. He said, I've come and paid your debt. I've paid the price. I've paid the wages right here. Now you can have freedom. You can have grace. You can have relationship with God. Amen? Amen? But then we continue in sin and like it. What did you just say? We continue in sin and like it. And like it. Right? Everybody's looking at me like, yeah, that's getting serious. Because it's real. Because we continue in sin and like it. Yet Jesus died, paid this price for us to have freedom, and we don't choose it. To have grace and we don't choose it. To have love and we don't choose it. We have all of these things, you know. And then the devil, man, look, I know the devil's the devil, right? We can't stand that guy, but he gets a bad rap most of the time because we're like, that devil made me sin. That devil tempted me. And most times it's us. It's us. You know who makes you sin? You. You do. You make you sin, right? It's not like the devil says, oh, look here, get on that website now. Look at it, he's got you by the hand. Go, I can't stop this, Lord. You know I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for the devil. He's controlling me right now. No, you give in to it. He has the power of suggestion. He tempts you. You act or refuse or rebuke temptation. Amen? Amen. 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 Right? I mean, that's tough, right? Man, that's hard, man. Wow. It's truth, though. It's truth. You can leave this service and be like, wow, that was great. Had the word of the Lord. You can go out there and get high, smoke, drink, cuss, walk out in that parking lot and look at pornography. It's up to you. You have the choice. God gave you free will. He's not going to take it from you. He said, I want to see if these people will love me out of choice. I want them to love me. I'm not going to force them to love me. I just want them. He wants relationship with us. That's why we say foo beyond religion and yes to relationship. It's a relationship with Him. He just wants your love. He wants your affection. He wants your time. Amen. He's already paid the price. He said it was finished. He has paid in full. He says, I have paid your debt. Why do you still live in sin? Why would you do that? John 3:17, for God did not send His Son to the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. I always like 17, right? Everybody's like, oh, John 3:16. John 3:16 is great, but look at 17. He didn't send Him to condemn. He didn't come down here to point His finger and shake a finger at us, right? The world can be saved through Him. We all run around every day heartbroken and misled and tore up and cannot figure out what is wrong with us, and all we need is Jesus. We all have that Jesus. You know, I'm looking at Jesus shapes hole in my heart, and I can't find anything else that fits it. I got a round pipe, I'm going to put a square in a round hole. You know what I mean? It's one of those things. You beat yourself to death when you need Jesus. You need time with Jesus, not the Xbox and the PlayStation and the phone and the iPad, not with the boyfriend and the girlfriend and Instagram and Snapchat and Facebook and everything else that's going to just split the gates of hell wide open. I'm convinced Snapchat and Instagram and all that, that's probably going to be like, okay. So anyway, all these things that take you away from the Lord, all these things that drive you and draw you away from Jesus, we give more time to it than we do to Him. But we can't understand why we're lacking, why we're sad, why we're depressed, why we're misled, why we're all confused. What's right? What's wrong? Well, I'm not really sure anymore. You know, I've got friends that say they're gay and bisexual, and I love them, but I don't know how to tell them that's wrong, and I'm not really sure if it is wrong anymore. I don't know. I'm just really trying to learn and figure this out for myself. You know what I mean? We're being misled. We're being misinformed. Get into the Word of God in relationship with Jesus, and you'll understand how to handle those things. Amen? But you've got to have a relationship with Him. You're going to be lost in a dark and dying world, and you're not going to know what to do and where to go. Amen? Without Him, you can be saved through Jesus. Jesus loves you. 1 Timothy 1:15, this is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance, that Christ Jesus came to the world to save sinners. And then He says, who I am chief. Are you going to feel like that sometime? Here He is, like, trying to write to Timothy and say, you know, here's a faithful and good saying right here. Christ came to the world to save all the sinners, and I am the chief sinner. Like, man, how can somebody like Paul say something like that? That's crazy, right? But that's how he was real. Right? Paul was real, right? We should be real, right? Sometimes I feel like the chief of all sinners. Why do I mess up? And I keep messing up every day. God, why? Why? Stop choosing sin. Stop liking to live in sin. Stop carrying around these pet sins that you like. Amen? Everybody gets saved. There's always like, everybody has like these five sins. If I had these five things, but then I got saved. Now I only got one. Yeah, I felt that. Almost all of you jumped up and said, that's right! I felt that right there, man. Yeah, you know. Because we know. We know. I had like five or six, man. Then I got saved. Now I got one or two. I stopped drinking and cussing and smoking, but I still look at porn. But I got saved. Jesus saved me. I still slip and drink every now and again because it says for the stomach's sake. That's the craziest, most twisted junk I've ever heard in my life. Stop making excuses for your sin with the Bible. Stop making excuses for your sin, period. We take God, we put it in a box, and we say, this fits my lifestyle, this is the gospel, this is my Bible. Here it is. Everyone see it? This fits me. This is how Charlie wants to live. I can do this and this, but I don't do this, this, and this. And shame on you for doing that. But I can. I can do this. Okay. Because this is my gospel and my God and my Jesus, and this fits my lifestyle. It makes me feel better. Right? And it's not the real, true gospel. It's not the real Bible, right? Amen? Golly, man, we had a youth service in a few weeks, man. You're going to come here and kick us right in the teeth. What's up with that, bro? Sorry. Take it up with the Lord. I told you this is, okay? Take it up with Jesus, man. Take it up with the Lord, okay? Don't shoot the messenger. John, 1 John 1 and 9 says, if we confess our sins, here's the great part about it, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness, which means a not right standing with God. Right? Unrighteousness. We're not in right standing with God. Get unrighteousness out of your life. He is faithful and just to forgive us. Jesus loves you. He wants to forgive you. He wants to give you grace. He wants to love you. He wants to give you mercy. He wants those things. That doesn't mean that He's just like every day, oh, I messed up, God. Click the, you know, just hit zero on the next day, right? Click me back to zero the next day. He loves you. He wants to forgive you. He wants to have right standing with you. But that doesn't mean every single day, well, your mercy and grace is renewed every morning. So that means I can sin every day. And as long as I don't die on the day that I've sinned, I'll be okay, right? As long as I die like in the morning on the way to school or in a crash or something, because you click back to grace and mercy, I'm back to zero, right? You erase the Lord, right? He loves you. If you will confess your sin, go to Him. You know, we say, God, oh, forgive me, Lord. I know I've been so bad. Just take these things away from me, God, and I'm sorry. Don't pray like that. Go up there and say, God, take pornography away from me. Take it out of my life. I hate this garbage. I don't want it ruling my life anymore. Get rid of it. I don't want to drink anymore. I don't want to cuss anymore. Whatever it is, go up there. God, I've got a bad mouth. I cuss. I get around my friends. I tell dirty jokes. I start saying cuss words because I want to fit in with them. And I stop thinking about you. Take cussing out of my vocabulary. Take it out of my language. I hate it. I don't want it anymore. God, take lying away from me. I don't want to lie anymore. I don't want to be a liar. I don't want to be fake. I don't want to be false. You know, call that stuff out. Call it out what it is. Amen. Don't just sit there, Lord, just forgive me of my sins. Forgive me of all these things. Call that junk out and get it out of your life. You have to almost be sick of it, right? It has to be like vomit to you. When stuff's about the dog returning back to its vomit, those sins should be like vomit to you. They should make you just gross you out. Amen. Sin should just gross you out. Anything, this cussing, lying, cheating, stealing, porn, drinking, whatever it is, right? It should just gross you out. And the people that you used to do those things with should just gross you out, right? Love them and pray for them, but doesn't mean you have to hang out with them, right? I've got some best friends I love to death, but I just can't be around them. Can't be around them. You know what I mean? Still to this day, you know, in November, it'll be 10 years. Sober, saved, praising the Lord, living for the Lord, going on 10 years. It's amazing. Woo! Oh, thank you. I couldn't go one day without drugs or alcohol or cussing or porn or anything else. It's hard to believe it's been 10 years. Look at that. You can live without it. Before I was like, I can't live unless I'm high. I have to be buzzed. I'm 10 years. You know what I'm saying? So you can do these things. But even in 10 years, I still have to remember this book, remember this word, remember what's going on. Confess sin, go after God every single day and be in right standing with Him, right? We can't get so lost in this. Well, I've just been in this thing for so long, right? To the Word. He loves you. He wants to forgive you. He wants relationship with you. Don't try to just go with the flow and fit in. 1 John 1, 5 and 6. This is the message which you have heard from Him and declared to you. God is light, and in Him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with Him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. Right? So if we say that we have fellowship with Him and walk in darkness, we lie and we don't practice truth. Our room, right? After a while, you start getting used to it, right? After a while, you're like, yeah, now I kind of know where everything is. Now you start seeing a little bit of a shadow. Eventually, that dark room becomes regular, right? Well, now I'm kind of okay with it. Now I'm starting to figure it out. Now I remember where I said everything, and I'm not tripping over anything. And eventually, a dark room in a dark place can make you seem like you're in a place of light because you get so used to it. You get so used to that atmosphere, being in that darkness, that you feel like you're in the light. You feel like you're in a good place, when in fact you're not. We've got to open our eyes, adjust your eyes to know God, to know Him for real, to walk in the light. What happens if you flip that light on, man? You know what I mean? Everything's exposed. Everything's lit up. Everything's real. Everything's true. Nothing can be false, right? Nothing can be false. All right. Titus 2, 11 through 13, for the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us denying ungodliness and worldly lust, teaching us that we should deny those things, deny ungodliness and worldly lust. We should live soberly, righteous, and godly in the present age, looking for the blessed hope and glorious appearance of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He is coming back. Amen. He said, I'm coming back. I'm coming back to get you. He even folded up the little face cloth and laid it down and said, I'm coming back. That means I'll be back. If he just took it off and threw it down and left it in a mess, not coming back. He even took time to fold that thing up to represent. That was representation in their culture. I'll be back. He's coming back. He is coming again. Don't be found in this mess, in this world. Amen. All right, Ephesians 1 and 6. Let us praise God for His glorious grace, the free gift He has gave us through His dear Son. Think about this, glorious grace. It's a free gift He has given us through Jesus Christ. It's free. It's a free gift. It costs you absolutely nothing, right, to obtain this thing. And everybody says, oh, yes, 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 it will. It'll cost you everything. Yes, it will. But you'll love every minute of it. You will love every minute of it. There's some pains. Yes, there's some suffering with God. Yes, there's some persecutions. But it's the best thing that ever happened to you. Amen. I mean, it's the best thing ever happened to you. The persecution that you face with Jesus Christ is the greatest thing that'll happen. Ephesians 2, 8, 9, for by grace you have been saved through faith and not through yourselves. This is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. It's nothing to do with us, amen? Nothing to do with us. Nothing we can boast about. Thank you, God, for saving me. Thank you, God, for all of these things, you know, in my life. But it's nothing I can brag or boast about. It's all about Jesus, amen? God, help us make the most of every day, amen? Every day. We should make the most of every single day, every time, every chance. Thank you, God, for the chance that you gave us, knowing how we would be, knowing how we were going to live. And I mean, he even lived among us. He created us, and he still gave us. And in John 3:3, Jesus answered him and said, most surely I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. We can't see it. Born again. Because we're born into sin the first time, right? We were born into sin, born into this world. We have to be born again into Christ Jesus, a new creation, made new, made clean, made over again. All right, everybody stand. Everybody stand. Any musicians, come on back up here. Shh, listen up. 2 Samuel 24:14, David said to God, I'm in deep distress. Let us fall into the hands of the Lord, for his mercy is great. But do not let me fall into human hands. Don't fall into human hands. People will take you. They'll be used by the enemy. They'll be used for their own violence. They will try to mold you. They will try to shape you. They will be what they want you to be. They'll make you into the friend that they want you to be, right? I've seen it happen. It happened to me. Don't fall into human hands. Listen, God has grace for you. God has love for you. God shows us mercy every day. Confess your sins to God and you will be saved. Confess, right? All these things, guys. Leave the world behind you. Don't get used to darkness. Don't get used to the dark room and the dark place. Lord and Savior. It's easy. I don't know how many of you guys in here need to rededicate your lives and need to make just a new commitment to God or to say, Lord, I don't want to keep getting tripped up. I don't want to keep going back to that one sin that I've held on to. You know what I mean? I had 5, now I've got 1. I had 10, now I've got 2. We got to let them go, right? Let all of them go. Make time for Jesus. Make time for the Lord. He loves you so much. And listen, here's the problem. Here's the thing. The world's not going to get any better. It's not going to straighten out. And it's not going to tell you the truth, okay? If anything, the world's going to get worse. It's in the Bible. It's the Word of God. Like, we hate it. We don't want to speak doom and gloom on ourselves. But the Bible tells us what will happen. You know what I mean? It's not going to get any better. It's going to get worse. You know what I mean? And even us, how much longer do you give the world the pace we're taking it? I mean, everywhere you look, mountains, trees, everything's being cleared off, houses, buildings, stuff going up everywhere. Technology's ruling the world. People are out of jobs right and left. You know, it's crazy, right? How much longer do you give the world? How much longer do you think Jesus gives the world? Before God just says, go, go. Wrap it up. Sound the trumpet. Let's go. Let's get ready. Get my people out of there. Start this thing up. Tribulation, here we come. Rapture, all that, right? Don't miss out on Jesus, amen? Don't miss out on this for anybody. For nothing. Why would you want to miss out on the love of God and heaven for anything or anybody? What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? You'll have your reward here. For what, 60, 80 years old? You lived to be 80 and I was a millionaire and had 4 or 5 houses all over the world. It was just amazing. You had that for 80 years. We're talking about eternity. Why would you gamble your eternity for 80 years here? When he says there's many mansions, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Something like we can't even imagine how beautiful. They try to describe heaven to us, and I don't think we can still grasp the beauty, how amazing it's going to be. And we get to be there with our Lord and Savior. Why would we trade that for that? Why would we trade something on earth? You mean think about that you're on earth as in heaven? We should be the same here on earth as we want to be in heaven, amen? Go after God with everything. Close your eyes right now. Close your eyes, bow your heads. And just press in. Just press in that moment. God, I don't want to miss you. I don't want to miss your plan for my life. I don't want to miss your will. I don't want to keep falling into a dark place. I don't want to keep falling into a hole, Lord. I don't want to keep missing what you have for me. I don't want to keep being led to temptation. I don't want to keep giving in to the same sin over and over and over that keeps trying to hang up in my life and hold on to me. I want real freedom. relationship. I don't want just religion. I don't want halfway. I'm tired of living ankle deep, knee deep, waist deep. I'm over it. I'm tired of that. I want full on over my head relationship with you, God. Tonight, if that's you, these altars are open. Come on, come to these altars. Let's get on these altars and begin to talk to Jesus. Begin to pray to Him. Don't forget who you're talking to, who you're talking about. God loves you. He's here to forgive you. He's here to love you. Make things right with God. Make things right with God. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. There's people here that will pray for you, that will pray with you. Make things right with God. If you haven't done it, you've got something burning on your heart, come up here and pray. Come over here and say, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you more than anything else. I want to be made right, God. I want to be made new, Father, in your sight. I want to be a young man, a young woman that stands up for the name of Jesus. I don't want to be used up by this world. I don't want to keep getting hung up on the same sins and the same things. I need you, God. And only you will do, Jesus. Only you will do, Jesus. I have to have you. I have to have you. God, right now, begin to move on these young men, these young women, Father. Right now, God. Even though they lived in sin, God, they were wanting to see you love them enough, God, to give them another chance to love them, Father. Bless them with grace, God. Help them, Jesus. Help them, Jesus. Right now, God, pour into them, God, pour into them. like special prayer for anything? You guys need healing, something coming up, family member, like anything? Like special prayer, like directional, bind our faith together, call it by the name type stuff. Like, I mean, purposeful stuff, like. Come up here. Gather around her. We're going to pray for her dad and her mom. We're going to lift them up right now. What is this specifically? Thanks to you. So we're going to pray for freedom right now. Pray for freedom for her mother and father away from drugs. Listen, so many people deal with this stuff every day. It's part of my life, part of my family. The people I knew, their mom and dads. I used to do drugs with my friends, moms and dads. It's real. It's every day. None of us should be shocked or appalled by any of this, right? But to say, listen, we're going to bind our faith with you. We're going to put our faith with Danny and say, we're going to believe that there is freedom. I know there's freedom. I've seen it. I've experienced it my own life. That they can be set free. They can be set free. I mean, believe it. Get all that down now. And just because you don't see it like that, don't give up. Don't let the devil beat you up over it. You keep praying and lifting him up because there is freedom. There can be freedom. Amen. All right, lift your hands. Lift your hands up there. Right now, just lay hands on your hands. Touch them. Father God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, we lift this young lady's mother and father up to you, God, right now. Lord, we bind our faith together. We speak freedom over these people, God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Move in their lives, Father, right now, right where they are, God. Freedom, God, we speak freedom from drug addiction right now. Drugs, we bind and rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Get out of their lives, out of their homes, God, right now, Lord. Put a sour taste in their mouth, God, that it just disgusts them every time, God, that they want to do whatever drug it is, God. Drink whatever they have, God. Whatever it is, Lord, right now, that it's just disgusting to them, God. It doesn't appeal to them anymore, Father. Right now, God, shake them away, God. Shake them away right now. In the name of Jesus, God, touch this young lady, Lord. Help her to stay strong. Increase her faith, God, right now in you, Lord. And for the freedom of her mother and her father, God, as she comes and stands in for them, God, right now. She's took a bold step of faith, God. She's believing for freedom right now, God. She's believing they'll be set free. God, we bind our faith together right now in the mighty name of Jesus, that there will be freedom in her house and freedom for her mother and her father right now. Right now. In the name of Jesus, God, let it be done. Give God a praise for it. Receive it. Believe it. Believe it. Amen. And praise Him for it. Praise Him for it. What you got? Now he can't hardly remember anything, all right? So we're going to pray for that young man right now. God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, touch this young man, Father, right now. Touch his head, touch his mind. God, we pray this concussion away from him right now in the name of Jesus. God, get this young man a miracle, Father, in his head right now in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we're believing miracles. We bind our faith together, God. We know you can do all things but fail, God. You can do all things but fail. And right now, Lord, we lift you up in the mighty name of Jesus. God, touch this young man as Jonathan stands in for him. God, we lift him up to you, Jesus, right now. We lift this young man up to you, Father. Place him into your hands, God, right now. We bind and rebuke this concussion. We command the mind and command the body to yield to the name and the commandment of Jesus Christ, that he is healed, that he will be healed right now. Where this young man is, his mind right now, we command you be healed. We command you straighten out right now. We command you concussion. Leave this young man's mind and his body right now by the mighty and powerful name of Jesus right now. We bind and rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise him. Praise God. Believe. Amen. Believe. Anybody else? Sickness off them. Amen? Amen. All right, you ready, Rebecca? Put your hand. Touch somebody who's touched her. It's all about connection. It's all about connecting. Right now, Jesus, God, right now, as Becca stands in for her, our grandmother, for Alyssa, God, right now, we bind any sickness right now. Sickness, we command you, leave their body in the name of Jesus. You have to yield to the name of Jesus, and we command you right now, sickness, leave their bodies right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Right now, no more sickness in their bodies. God, begin to do a miracle in their lives right now. Touch them, heal them, Father, right now by your word. And as she stands in, as we touch her, God, and bind our faith together right now, we command sickness. We bind and rebuke you. We command you to leave their bodies in the name of Jesus. Let it be done right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise Him. Praise Him. Yes, God, let it be done. Let it be done, Father. We also listen to you together. Good report. They had new tests on him today, Michael, one of our very own, amen, one of our brothers right here. They had new tests on his heart today. They're waiting on the report to come back, and we're believing for a good report, amen. How many believe it's going to be a good report? There you go, everybody, yeah. All right, let's pray right now. Dear Heavenly Father, God, right now, as we lift Michael up to you, God, right now, this report will be good, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, God, whatever's going on with his heart and his chest right now, listen, right now, we command you, chest, we command you, heart, right now, in the name of Jesus. Be healed right now. Whatever's going on in there, God, we're believing for a good report right now. Whatever's going on inside this young man's body, Lord, whether it be in his heart, God, right now, in his lungs, in his chest, whatever the problem is, God, if it's rhythm, whatever it is, we command your heart right now to straighten up right now. We command his heart right now. Listen, right now, heal in the name of Jesus right now. Go back in rhythm. Beat. No palpitations right now in the name of Jesus, God. This report is going to be good. You're going to touch this young man, God. We know we believe you, God, for all things, God, through us and through our faith, God. We know it's not us, but it's you, God. But you working through us, Father. Touch this young man right now. Bring him into his body in the name of Jesus. Amen. Believe it.
Yeah, amen.
Good report. Good report. Amen. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Uncle and his dad. So his uncle, when Rachel's been talking about, has cancer. And his dad, you know, he knew the Lord for a long time. He's been in and out of church and in and out of church. So we're going to believe that the Lord takes hold of him. Amen. And that Rachel Mason's going to be a good example to him. And the Lord will take hold of him. And he will be found in a right relationship with Jesus again. Amen. In righteousness with the Lord. Pray. When we pray, pray like it's your dad. Pray like it's your uncle. Pray like it's your family. Amen. Like it was yours. I mean, how would you pray? If you were standing right here and said, would y'all pray for my uncle and dad? Would you want somebody behind you going, oh, yes, Lord, thank you. You said, touch me if you can. Or would you want somebody pressing in and really praying, right? So press in and really pray. Right now, God, touch his father. Right now, in the name of Jesus, God, get him out of this unrighteous place, God, and get him back into righteousness with you, Father. I know you love him, God. You love Shannon, God. You'll never leave him alone, Father. You'll never stop pursuing him, God. He'll never find rest until he's back in a right relationship with you, Jesus. Touch him, God, right now. Shake him, God, to the core, Father, right now, God. Whatever it takes, Lord, save his life, God. Bring him back to you and back to a right relationship with you, Father. And right now, his uncle, God, we bind and rebuke cancer. Cancer right now. The spirit of cancer, we bind and rebuke you. We command you to leave his uncle's body right now as he stands in for him cancer right now. Listen right now to the word of Jesus Christ. We bind and rebuke you. We command you to leave his uncle's body in the name of Jesus Christ, that he will experience a miracle in his body. He will experience a healing miracle right now in his body. Cancer, we command you to leave his uncle's body now in the name of Jesus Christ. Be gone right now. We bind and rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Cancer, be gone right now. Dry up and die, cancer. Right now, we command you to dry up out of this man's body right now, cancer. We command you to dry up and rebuke you in the name of Jesus right now. Be gone out of his body right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Our dad said, pray for her dad. He's been doing drugs ever since he's been married to your mom. So right now, morphine, drugs and alcohol. Let me tell you something. It starts right here. It wrecked my life. Started at 14 years old. How many of you guys are 14 or older? Yeah, most of you. 14 years old. Ruined my life. Ruined my life. And now we've got another young lady, probably some more of you guys in here, dealing with drugs, alcohol. That stuff is garbage. It will ruin a family. It will ruin a family. Amen. Right now, we're going to pray and believe for her dad right now. Right now. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, touch this man, Father, right where he is right now, Jesus. God, we bind and rebuke drugs in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that he has a bitter feel and taste to him, God, that he's not satisfied with it anymore, God. Shake him, God, right now to his core, Father. Right now, as this young lady stands in for him, God, right now, no more. No more in the name of Jesus. He won't find rest. He won't find peace until he is off of those drugs. And those drugs are out of them and out of their family, God. We bind and rebuke drugs right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We command right now the spirit. We command it off of this man's body right now. That no longer does he want to feel this high or feel this buzz anymore. Help these young women, God, to go after him, to pray for him, to lift him up to you, Father. To not be shaken in their faith, God, that we believe that there is deliverance, there is freedom in the name of Jesus. And if you set them free, God, it says they're ties to this mess that's going to kill him, God, if he don't get off of this stuff. Right now, we're asking for freedom, for cleansing, for purity. Right now, we command this spirit, this drugs, off of this man's life right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God for freedom. Amen. Praise God for freedom. Who else? Who else? For Caitlin. Okay, she was standing for Caitlin. Caitlin's had a lot going on. If y'all remember Caitlin, she's had a lot of stuff going on in her family and things like that. It's personal issues and things like that that's been happening. You know, there's family matters. But we want to pray for Caitlin and lift her up. I talked to her, texted her a little bit today. I was actually talking to her, told her that we missed her. She said she had to figure some things out between her and her family and had to get off on her own. You know, sometimes she's going to get away and figure things out on her own. But we want to, Rachel's going to stand in for Caitlin. We're going to lift her up in prayer. All right. Dear Heavenly Father, God, right now, touch Caitlin, God, right where she's at. God, we know you have a plan for this young lady. God, we know how much you love her, God. How she just loves you, God. She was on such a fire for you, God. I pray that fire remains, God. I pray that fire burns so bright, Father. Help her in this situation. Help her through this hard time, God. To mend a bond with her family, God. To mend her family, God. This brokenness, this hurt, this pain, these expectations, whatever it is, Father. Mend them back together, God. Take this brokenness out of this family, God. Mend them back together, God. Whole, God, and mighty, and in love, God. And in patience and forgiveness, God. In grace and mercy with one another, Father. Right now, God, we lift her up to you, Father. Right where she is, God. Let her feel your love and your grace surround her, God. Just wrap all around her right now. You're going to bring healing. We know that you're going to bring meaning back to her family in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise Him. Amen. Praise God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wes, Valerie, yeah. So we're going to pray for her brother and her dad, right? We're going to pray for Nathan and Stephen. However you guys know, we're going to lift them up in prayer and believe for them. Amen. For freedom, for right standing, for clarity in their minds, right? God, what did he do when he got to Gadarenes? He healed that man. They said was out of his mind. And what they did, they found him clean. And he's right. He's done it before. In the Bible, he's done this before. Healed, mental health, restored. He's restored it. And we're going to believe it for them right now. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, God, right now, as we lift up Stephen and Nathan unto you, Father, right now, God, touch them, God. Restore this mental health, God. Drive away these evil spirits. Drive away the drugs, Father. Drive away everything, God. Save these lives, God. Right now, Jesus, drive it back, God. We bind and rebuke these spirits. We bind and rebuke drugs. We bind and rebuke everything that's coming against these men, against their minds, Lord, that the enemy wishes to sift them as weak, God. But right now, it's never stands in for them, God. Devil, you can't have them. Enemy, you can't have them. You can't have them. You can't have their minds. We're taking it back right now in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. We command their minds be healed. Mental health restored in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. You've done it before. You can do it again, God. I know you, God. You've done it for the man of the Gadarenes, God. You've restored his mental health. Go into these men right now, God. Right now in the mighty name of Jesus, restore mental health, God. God, take back the ground that the enemy has stolen from these men, God. Right now, Father, we get to move over them right now, God. They want to change. They need a change, God. Right now, shake them, God. Shake them away. Shake them to their core that they're not satisfied with this life. They're not satisfied where they're at right now, God. And they know they need you, God. Right now, wake them up, God, and drive them back to a right relationship with you, God. As the prodigal son came back to the father, God, help them, God. Shake them back to their senses, God, that they come to themselves, God. And they know where they need to be, that they need to be in their father's house, God. That they wake up, they say, I don't want the pigsty anymore, God. I'm running back to the father. I know where I'm found. I know where I have peace and grace and mercy and love. And I'm running back to the father. We pray this over them right now, God. Restore, restore, God, and give them freedom, God. And restore their mental health, God, right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Praise Him for a miracle. Amen. Praise Him for miracles. Amen. Restoration and restore. And believe it. What would you do? What would you do if your uncle called you and said, I don't have cancer anymore? What would you do if you heard Stephen call you or Nathan call you and say, I'm fine? What would you do? We said, oh my gosh, wow. It worked. Believe like that. That it's going to work. That it's going to happen. Amen. I'm just going to keep saying prayers for them and hope. Every time you pray for them, pray like you believe you're going to get a phone call. I'm not on drugs anymore. I've been sick. I don't want that anymore. Please forgive me. I want forgiveness and freedom now. I don't want to live like that anymore. I don't want drugs anymore. I've been shaken to my core, right? I don't want it anymore. You talk to your friend, hey, I'm fine. I don't know what happened. Around 8:30 last night, something weird started happening. My head started tingling, and I'm fine. But 8:30 last night, I came out. I mean, what would you? That's why you praise God. You praise Him for it. Thank you for healing. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for forgiveness. Thank you, God, for letting it be so and letting it be done. Because that's who He is. That's who He is. We say, God, if it be your will. Well, I read everywhere He went, His will was to heal, forgive, love, and restore. Everywhere He went. Where does it say, no, it's not my will? You know, I mean, He challenged the one lady that said, no, hey, I'm on my way right now to bless the children of Israel. She said, well, don't even the dogs get the crumbs from the table? He said, boom. You show me a little bit of faith? Yes, they do. Boom, right there, right? She wasn't satisfied with just, oh, I'm sorry to bother you, Lord, keep moving. But she showed Him some faith, and what He do? He honored it. He honored it. Just show God some faith sometimes. He'll honor it. Amen? Anybody else?
Don't be disrespectful, right? Do it out of love. You
disrespectful, they're not going to receive anything you're doing out of anger or hate or disrespect. Do it out of love. And if you got to, I'm sorry I love you, Dad. I'm sorry I want to see you go to heaven. I'm sorry I care enough about you to pray for you. I'm sorry I care enough about you that I want to point out, you know, and just help you be better. I'm sorry. Forgive me for loving you and wanting you to go to heaven. What are they going to say to that? Go to your room. Maybe. Fine, I don't know. And then they're like, you know what I mean? It'll resonate. It'll resonate with them. It will. It resonates with them. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Yep. Your aunt has cancer. All right, her aunt has cancer. Listen. Bind and rebuke cancer. Tell it to dry up. Tell it to die. Command it to leave. These healings, a lot of times you see a healing, it's a command, right? It's a command. Right? Don't, like I said, don't, Lord, if it's your will, Jesus, please. Command. Say, body, listen, cancer, dry up. You know how many times I've heard people talk about the spirit of cancer? I mean, it's everywhere. Why don't you think they found cures for only certain things in cancer? You're like, how do we come up with like a coronavirus in a year? Been working on cancer for over 40 or 60 years and can't do it. Could be because it's a spirit. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, we bind and rebuke cancer off of this woman's life, God. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, the spirit of cancer, the sickness of cancer, dry up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We bind you, rebuke you, and command healing into her body right now. We command you, cancer, to leave right now. We command her body to be healed, to be well, where this cancer is, God. Right now, a healing into her body, God, a miracle. Right now, Father, we're asking for this cancer to dry up and be gone from this very day, Father, this very second, God. Cancer, we command you dry up this spirit of cancer. This young woman stands in for her hand, God. Right now, a miracle, Father. Miracles right now in this house, Father, in this woman's life, God. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, we command you cancer to leave. We command you cancer dry up. This spirit right now, this darkness of cancer, die and dry up. Rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Let it be done right now. Let it be done. Let it be done right now. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And let it be done. Yes. Spirit of cancer. It's everywhere. It runs great. How many different kinds of cancer is there? Every time you turn around, when you get your arms, shoulders, toes, foot, neck, legs, everywhere, lungs, you get cancer everywhere. It bounces everywhere. They can only treat it to any certain extent, right? But God can heal all. Amen. Heal it all. It doesn't matter. Anybody else for me?
Stage 4 colon cancer.
They said, you're going to die. We've done everything we can do. You're at stage 4 colon cancer. You're going to die now. Family come in, getting ready to die. Jesus healed her.
Amen.
Jesus healed her. She's the clerk here. She'll talk to her. She's here tonight. Y'all want to talk to her. Y'all have this cancer. Shelly is the clerk. And now she runs a cancer ministry. Everybody says, why would someone let, why would the Lord let somebody go through all 4 stages of cancer and then heal her? Now she has a cancer ministry. That's her heart. Now she knows how to handle and talk and minister to people in stage 1, 2, 3, or 4. She knows exactly what they're dealing with at what stage because she went through it all. That's her ministry now. Stage 4, we've done all we can do. And then God said, you've done all you can do. Now let me do what I can do. Healed. Amen. Healed. She was healed of cancer. I don't know how many people we've had healed of cancer. We can buy and rebuke that junk off. Drugs can go. Drugs can get out of here. They got no place. Amen. They have no place in this. We just got to get them out. We got to get them out of here. It's just trying to overtake the world. Amen. All the more reason to share and spread the love of Jesus Christ and this gospel. That's why. It's not just because, well, the young pastor says, and I'm a Christian. That's how I'm supposed to be. Drive that darkness in people's lives. The same people. You walk by in the hallway. What are they dealing with at home? Is their mom and dad in church? Is somebody dying in their family? Right? I mean, think about it. You're passing years bumping elbows with them in the hallway. What are they going through? Your testimony might save their life. Who's depressed? Who's suicidal? You know what I mean? Share it. Spread it. I mean, golly, all I can do is tell you no or get away from me, weirdo. Okay. You know what I mean? We call that persecution. I'm being persecuted for your name's sake, Lord. They told me to beat it. I'm sharing in your suffering. Beat him after death. I mean, they killed him on the cross. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? For Alex. Anything specifically?
Just that
it's drawing back to relationship with God.
Yeah.
There's a lot of young men, they battle anger and you know what I mean? And being a young man, there's a lot of responsibility for finding your own way, the macho man way, and I know what's right for me and all that kind of stuff. But she's going to stand in for Alex. We're going to pray that Alex is found. He loves the Lord. He knows the Lord. The Lord's not going to stop pursuing him. He's not going to let him go that easy. Amen. He'll be one of them who has to go head on strong until he hits rock bottom, just like I did before he starts looking back up. We're going to pray for Alex. The Lord softens his heart. Take this anger out of him, grace and love, and then he'll come back to a right relationship with Jesus. Lord, right now, as we bind our faith together, as Ashley stands in for Alex, God, right now, touch this young man. God, soften his heart. Soften his emotions. God, touch him. God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, give him no rest, God, until he's back in a right relationship with you, God. He'll just be running in place, God, running and just spinning his wheels, God, until he knows you again, God, until he's found back in the house of the Lord, God, until he loves you with his mind, his heart, his soul, God, all of his strength, Father. God, right now, Lord, help him, Father. Soften his heart, soften his mind, God, right now, open him up, God, to your word, to your spirit, God. Heed, God, that you will heed the call, Father, and run back to the Lord, run back to you, Jesus. That God, right now, we pray that we lift this young man up to you, God, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. We bind our faith together, God, that you will come back to you. Soften him, God, take this anger out of him, God, take this headstrong out of him, God. Soften him, God, use him, God, that he can be used of your will to share and spread this gospel, Father. Right now, as we bind our faith together, move in this young man's life, move in his situation, God. Bring him back to you, Father. Bring him back stronger than ever before, Father. Right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we're believing all this to be done in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. Thank you for freedom. Thank you for freedom. Thank you for restoration. Softening hearts. Anger. Drive bitterness. All that stuff. Unforgiveness. Get all that out of you. Get all that out of you. We were all made in his image. How are you going to hate somebody, be mad at somebody, fight somebody? You know what I mean? Cuss somebody? Oh, they made me mad. What did they do to him? He's hanging on a cross, man. They just beat him and killed him and ripped everything. And he says, forgive them, God. They don't know what they do. Somebody shoots us with spit water. I'm going to hit you in the face. You blankety blank blank. Oh, that was the flesh. Sorry, I got the flesh. Yes, I'm a Christian. I got the flesh. That's what we always say around the church. I got the flesh. Forgive me. Don't live in the flesh then. Stop living in the flesh. We're supposed to live in the flesh. Amen. We're supposed to crucify every day. Every morning we wake up, pick up your cross, crucify the flesh, walk with Jesus. Right? We don't have, I got the flesh anymore. You know what I mean? Get rid of that stuff. Get over that stuff. All right, anybody else real quick? Can we have Kevin ask her and get you guys out of here? Probably a parking lot full of people standing out there going, tell the parents to come in here. We're going to lay hands on them now. Tell them to come in here. Anybody else? All right, let's pray. Forgive. pray for safety over Jonathan right now, and everybody else too on his team and stuff, young men in sports and things like that, with the concussions and broken bones and everything else. Let's pray safety over all of our young people, all of our schools, all of our sports, amen. Father, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, we pray safety, Father, over our young athletes, God, over these schools, Father. Be with them in school, God, and out of school, Father, and in practices, Lord, and in games, Father. We pray protection, God, and God, safety over them right now, Lord, each and every single one of them, God. Put a hedge of protection around them, God, and your hand upon them, Father. Right now, Lord God, we praise you for protection. We praise you for safety, for God, the things that you do that we don't even know about or see. And you protect us, the things you do for us every day that we don't even know about, God. We thank you and we praise you for that, God, and for who you are and how much you love us, God. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah.
All right,
now, we're going to pray now.
All right, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord God, for your love, mercy, and kindness. God, thank you once again, Father, for meeting us in this place, God, for being here, being with these young men and young women. God, thank you for the time that we got to share with you tonight, God, for the things that we lifted up to you in prayer on these altars, God. We're believing you, Jesus, for them to be done, God, that we will see these things come to pass. We will see these things come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus, God. It can be done, Father, and it will be done, God. We're believing you for it, God. We're believing you for all of these things we lifted up in prayer tonight, God. We love you. We praise you, God. Bless these young men and young women, God, going forward. Be with them tomorrow, God. Help them to share and spread the gospel, to reach out, tell somebody Jesus loves them, and to share their testimony, God, to pray for one another, God. Right now, God, we ask that you bless and cleanse us through in Jesus' name. And everybody say, amen. You guys are awesome. I love you all. Go back here and get some cake and ice cream as you're going out the door.